Hey, what's up? This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com, here with a video on the new PC I just built. My previous PC I built in about 2011, died a few months ago, so I've been using my laptop, which is fine because my laptop was newer than the PC and I was able to edit videos and stuff on it. But I wanted to build a new one, so this is kind of like my main PC as far as, like, you know, handling all my video editing and, you know, some sound design and different things like that. So I want to just kind of go into what I decided to get and kind of put it together. This is not going to be a video showing you how to put together a PC, or I'm not going to show the whole build process, but along the way I'll kind of talk about a few different things that I like about the parts and the devices that I picked out. So let's get into it.
All right, so just showing you the stuff I got. This is a Silent Bass 601 case. It's got the sound dampening and stuff in there. I might open it up later and show you. That's the MSI video card. It's an 8 gig, obviously, you know, so I can do some 4K. We'll see how it works. I may end up upgrading that. Got the B550 MSI motherboard, which is dope. It's the AM4 socket, but I can also upgrade to the latest gen of Ryzen processors. I ended up getting the 3900. So I know the 5900s or the 5000 series just came out, but those things are gonna take a minute to be in stock, so I didn't feel like waiting. 4 hard drives. I got 2 NVMe Western Digital Blacks and 2 Western Digital Blue, all 1 terabyte. It's a CPU cooler from Be Quiet, just Dark Rock Slim. I got an extra Silent Wings case, just because this case, because it's quiet, it's, you know, all this stuff is closed off, so, you know, want to get some good airflow. Got a Seasonic fully modular 750 watt power supply, which should be good. And I ended up getting 128 gigs of RAM, so yeah, should be cool with it, obviously, you know, Microsoft Windows. So yeah, all right, just wanted to show you the inside of the case. Super clean. Got the shroud down here for the PSU power supply. So there's one fan, there's already another fan in there. I'm gonna put another one up there. This is like hard drive bays, which they come in from the back. And then right here behind the motherboard is where I can put 2 SSDs. So that's where those 2 SSDs are gonna go. And then obviously the NVMe joints are gonna go directly on the motherboard. So yeah, that's why I end up getting this case. Plus it's gonna be quiet. So we'll see. Well, it's supposed to be quiet. It's got a little rail up top and stuff if you're doing like water cooling and all that, but we should be good. So yeah, I'll put that in there. And then just to, I can't really show it, but the hard drive, if I were to use it, they just come in like that and they all stick out. So I'd put like 2 SSDs in one of those cages, or a regular size drive, which I'm not using any regular size drive, so that's gonna be all open. So yeah, just wanted to show you the what the inside of the case looks like. Just wanted to show you the motherboard before I put all the stuff on it. There's your 2 M.2 or NVMe heat sinks. Got the antennas on the back because it has Wi-Fi built in. Obviously, CPU, memory, all that stuff. So definitely pick this one out for the features, but also I like how subtle it looks. Nice, clean look. So yeah. So I'm getting ready to apply the paste and throw the CPU cooler on, or just put the brackets on. See them right there with the little standoffs. This is the cooler. I got the Slim Rock from Be Quiet. That's the fan that goes on it. I just wanted to show you that before I did it. If you're ever building, take heed to that warning. Make sure you take that off before you put the paste on there and put your CPU on. Just don't forget that. So, yep, about to put that on now. Here's a quick look at the motherboard in the case before I start hooking everything up. I like it. I like how it looks in there. All right, so another thing I like about this case is this SSD tray. It just sits on the back of the motherboard and it's just one screw, so I can put it back in there and tighten it up. So yeah, I like that. Don't worry about these cables. We're gonna get that cleaned up in a minute. All right, we got the memory and the video card in. So now I'm not gonna button it all the way up yet. Still got to put this one in, and I still got to hook up the other 2 SSDs, but I'm not going to do that right now. Next, I'm going to power it on, see if it powers up. This motherboard has the LEDs on it, so if there's any error codes, like if there's a problem with the CPU or the memory or anything, we should be good. But what I want to do is power it up and get into the BIOS so that I can set the boot device so I can install Windows. Once I install Windows on that main NVMe, then I'll connect the other hard drives. But that's pretty much it. You'll be able to see it better once I get it all buttoned up. So a lot of this that you see back here is really on the back. So if I come over this way, maybe you can see a little bit better. So all the cables are pretty much going through there. It's a little dark in there, but you get it. All right, let's see. I may have to plug it up to the internal video card first. I just got some random stuff to test with. But I got it plugged in, so I got the Wi-Fi on there. So. See what happens. Nope. We got something. Let's see, it's my processor. The RAM device. So I should be able to go into the BIOS and set it so I can boot and start installing Windows. All right, so I'm good to go. Just gotta put the front panel and the side panel back on, but just want to give you a quick little look at it. Once it's done, so nice and clean. Don't got a lot of cables because I'm using all SSD. Run super quiet. Looking forward to seeing how it sounds when I'm editing video, 4K and stuff like that, but yeah. That's it. Oh yeah, real quick before I put it back together, I want to show you the sound dampening material that's inside this case. Pretty cool. So, yep.
Alright, so hopefully you guys enjoyed that. I'm definitely digging the build so far. I've already edited some video on it. Works fine. Don't have to lower my resolution when I'm editing 4K video and all that type of stuff, which is super dope. Also, it stays quiet when I'm editing, when I'm rendering, all that. So I definitely feel like I'll be able to get a lot of use out of this for many years to come. Hopefully another 10, 12 years, because it has the specs to, you know, pretty much take me, unless I start trying to get into 8K video and, you know, something like that. But as it stands right now, I think I'll be able to use this for what I do for a long time. So I'll put all the links in the description in terms of the parts and pieces. If you guys are interested, definitely check out those links. It helps out the site, helps out the channel. Also, if you would have chosen something different for, you know, different components and different parts of the system, let me know what you think, man. I'm always interested in talking tech. I love tech. So just being able to talk and hear your guys' input on that type of stuff definitely will be cool as well. Of course, if you got any questions, let me know. And if you're looking for plugins, presets, sample packs, tutorial courses, whatever, stop by the Sounds and Gear shop. Definitely helps out the site and the channel. Till next time, I'll see y'all later. Peace.